So I wanted to get this on video for you guys because it was pretty interesting. So I'm working on a Ridgid compressor here, and I'll put a video on screen to show you guys how this operates. And on this model, it has what's called a bullwhip throttle control. So as your tanks pressurize, it pushes a little piston inside of that little brass fitting, and then that piston pushes against a physical cable, and then that physical cable goes up to your governor throttle arm right there, and then as your tanks fill up, it pushes that cable, and that cable moves your governor right there to slow the RPM of your engine. So I'm going to fire this unit up here. There we go. Working as it should. So once the tanks build pressure, it pushes that piston, which then pushes that cable and lowers your throttle. This is working as intended, guys. So I've cleaned the carburetor on this thing. It fires up first pull now, and I've changed the oil on not only the engine, but also on the compressor as well, using, for this particular compressor, an ISO 100 compressor oil or a synthetic 10W30. So that's it. This machine is now ready to be returned back to my customer. So you guys saw how the bullwhip throttle control works, and it's quite simple, and it works good. It's been tested. Now, the issue here is that occasionally this machine will just kind of die out when it gets real hot. And my customer thought that it could possibly be just a bad coil, so that once the coil heats up, it just simply stops producing spark. And then once it cools down, it fires right up, he said. Now, usually that is a carburetor fuel supply issue. So once the engine gets real hot, the engine produces so much heat that it starts to vaporize the fuel in the carburetor before it gets into the cylinder. Now, on these models and a lot of other models, they have a little plastic spacer in between the engine and the carburetor. And that plastic spacer is essentially just to create a space so that it limits the amount of heat or thermal radiation from the engine to the carburetor. But it's not the carburetor that's causing this issue. It is in fact an ignition issue or a spark issue. So my customer owns a roofing company, and basically he wanted the coil replaced regardless of whether the old one tested bad or not, because he just wants a new part on it because this compressor makes him a ton of money. So I went ahead and replaced the coil. Now, interestingly enough, this is the high tension lead or the spark plug wire. You'll notice it is missing the cap. So I've gone ahead and removed that because when I tested the coil, I tested it without the spark plug cap on, and it tested to 5,800 ohms of resistance. Now, when I put the old cap from the old coil on there, I was getting about 15,000 ohms of resistance, and that's an issue. So on my workbench here, I have the old cap, and you guys can see right there, 10K ohm. So I did just a resistance check on this cap from where it hooks up to the spark plug, and there's a little screw. You guys won't be able to see it, but there's a little screw in here, and basically you just thread it onto your spark plug wire or your high tension lead, and that screw makes a good connection with the wire inside of it. So I've done a resistance reading on this, because when I tested the new coil with this old cap on, I was getting approximately 16,000 ohms of resistance, so it was about 15.9. So we were getting our 5,900 ohms of resistance on the coil, plus an additional 10 just from this cap. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys, and I have my multimeter here set to ohms, and I have it set on the 20K or 20,000 range. So I'm just holding one probe to the one terminal and the other probe at the other end where it screws onto the high tension lead. It's reading 10.16, so that is 10,000 ohms of resistance. Now I'm going to go ahead and check the new one and show you the difference. So I have my new spark plug cap here hooked up the same way. My setting on my multimeter is still at 20,000 ohms, and we're getting a reading of 4.75 or 4.74 there. So that's approximately 4,700 ohms. So essentially what's happening is we're getting twice the amount of resistance, well, more than twice the amount of resistance out of this old cap here. And that's gonna cause a major issue when the engine heats up. What's happening is because there's an added resistance here, that's gonna take away from the voltage or the spark that your coil is sending to the spark plug. So that's gonna result in a weaker spark directly at your spark plug. So I'm gonna go ahead and install this new cap. It's quite simple. You just pop it onto the wire and then you thread it on just like you would a nut onto a bolt. Okay, so I'm just doing a coil test with my new high tension lead cap on. I have one probe hooked to the spark plug cap and I have the other pinned down to the kill wire or the low oil sensor wire. And we're getting a reading of 10.5 on 20K. So we're getting just over 10,000 ohms of resistance. And that's as good as I can do right now, guys, because if you have one of these caps with a high resistance, basically what that means is there's just a little bit of condensation that's got into the cap most likely and caused some corrosion. So what that'll do is it'll build up the resistance. And again, like I said, it will limit the amount of spark traveling from your coil down your high tension lead to your spark plug cap there, and then thus resulting in limited spark at your spark plug. But I know this thing ran good before. You heard it in the video running, the bullwhip throttle control kicked down, everything worked perfectly, but the only thing is it shut down once it got real, real hot. But at least with the new coil and the new spark plug cap installed, we were able to lower the amount of resistance throughout the entire unit here by about 5,000 to 6,000 ohms of resistance. So that should make a difference, and hopefully it solves the issue of this engine dying out when it's hot. And just so you guys have the part numbers here, there's your ignition coil part number, and we have our little spark plug cap numbers there. So I'm gonna pull this out of the bag and we're gonna test that one as well. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna be testing here is what's known as the primary winding. So we're gonna be testing here with one probe on the kill wire, or that's also the low oil shutoff wire. So we're gonna go from the kill wire connector to the base, and with our multimeter set at 20K, or 20,000 ohms of resistance, we're gonna see that we're getting approximately 0.00. So that's actually lower than spec, because if we look at this little picture here, you guys are gonna see that the spec for the primary winding from the kill wire to the base is 0.8 to 1 ohms of resistance, and you guys can see here that we are only getting zero. So there's no resistance between those two connectors. Now, to test the secondary winding of this coil, we're going to be testing from one probe on the laminated base and the other probe at our high tension lead here. And we can see that we're testing at about 6.02. And again, at the 20K range, that is approximately 6,000 ohms of resistance. So essentially, this coil does test good, even though we do have low resistance in between those connectors. I don't foresee that being an issue, because with this old coil here installed, you guys heard it for yourselves, it ran perfectly. And again, with this cap here testing out at 10,000 ohms of resistance and the new cap only testing out at about 4, essentially we're lowering the total resistance by about 6,000 to 7,000 ohms of resistance. So hopefully this does solve the issue. So on the Honda tech forums, the spec for the cap itself, ideally you want it to be under 5,000 ohms of resistance. So essentially, if you had a coil testing at 5.9, let's say 6,000 ohms, plus an additional 5,000 ohms on your cap, you're gonna get a final reading from the cap to the coil of approximately 11,000 ohms of resistance. Now, we know that this cap here tested at just over 4,000 ohms of resistance, and this old spark plug cap here tested at 10,000 ohms of resistance, which is literally twice the amount of resistance that Honda recommends this cap to be tested at. So this thing is going in the garbage. I can show my customer once he shows up to pick this machine up. Basically, I'll just throw the multimeter to it, show him. But I have heard occasionally of these Honda GX series engines having intermittent coils. So what'll happen is they'll work when you're bench testing them. So you'll remove it, you'll test it, doing the same thing that I'm doing. It will test okay. You put it on, you run it, it might run all day, and then it'll just die all of a sudden. and then you let it cool down and it'll start back up again and it'll run okay. It doesn't happen that often, but it does happen every now and then. So the only way to fix this issue is to just simply replace the coil and go ahead and replace the cap as well, guys. These are, I think they run about anywhere from $15 to $20. I know it seems a little bit expensive, but when you have a piece of equipment like this that can, you know, make your company thousands and thousands of dollars doing roofing jobs, then $60 to $80 for a coil and $15 to $20 for one of these caps, it's not that much money. So one last thing before I throw this together, I went ahead and just lubricated with some grease the throttle control here just to make sure that it snaps back every time, which it does. So that should be good to go. So I got the compressor outside. I'm gonna fire it up, see how it runs. Runs good so far. There's the kickdown. So if I opened up the safety valve, it would let air out of the tank, and then it would kick the RPMs up to refill the tank. And just so you guys know, I set the high idle to approximately 3600 RPM. So I just used my tachometer there, and I can show you guys that if you want to see it. So I have here a single cylinder wireless tachometer. So basically, if you're checking RPM on a small engine that's under 5000 RPM, you're going to want to set it to the low RPM. You can see low up to 5000, and all you do is you hold this and it'll give you your reading, and you just put this spring on the high tension lead or the spark plug wire. So I'll show you how this works. Okay, so I'm over by the engine. I'm gonna turn this on. You guys are gonna see the RPMs go right there. So we're at approximately 1800 RPM on low. And then what I can do is come over here and pull the safety valve, and that'll release some pressure and cause the bullwhip throttle control to kick this up back to high RPM. So this thing runs perfectly, guys. It's ready to go back to my customer.
So if you guys enjoyed the video, think about leaving me a thumbs up. You know, it really helps me out. You can click here to subscribe and click over here to watch one of my previous videos. I upload every single week, so be sure to come on back next week. Check the channel out for new content. And as always, guys, thanks for watching.